Well, Dave, only 4 hours left. 4 hours to the end of the new year.
The year is winding down. If you made a New Year's resolution, you only have 4 hours left to accomplish it if you haven't done it yet.
You know, I'm the kind of person that works best on a deadline, but this is maybe a little bit ridiculous to try to squeeze it in before the end. Speaking of New Year's resolutions, are you looking at anything big for 13?
You know, I think I just want to continue to improve in all aspects of my life. I had a great professor, David Parrish, and he always said that your goal should be continued improvement in every aspect of your life, mentally, physically, spiritually, and I think that's an all-around good way to look at things. So as far as specifics, I guess I only have 4 hours to decide, but I haven't hammered out anything too specific.
So, okay, maybe nothing real specific, but you want to improve overall. It's lofty, but I think achievable. You know, we've done a lot in 2012. Man, has this show come a long way.
We sure have.
In 2012.
A lot of people helped us get there.
Yeah, we were talking before we start broadcasting tonight about the number of guests we've had. We've done a total of
25 songs, I think.
25 songs?
23 or 25, yeah. Somewhere in there, yeah.
And we're going to be reviewing some of those.
Yeah. You always mention, and I say the same thing, music, local live, local music, that's part of the essence of what going live with Faith TV is, and it's part of the, you know, it's the crux of the show. It's one of our favorite parts of the show, too.
Sure. I always get amped up whenever I hear them doing a run through that evening. Mm-hmm. We're going to do a review of a lot of the music that we did throughout the year, and we're going to be doing that for the next couple hours. But tonight, we have a studio audience at 10 p.m. In fact, they're starting to file in here. They'll be coming in within the next hour or so. But we have some wonderful music that's coming up tonight during that 10 o'clock hour.
Yeah, we sure do. We have Harold Betters, Mr. Trombone.
Mr. Trombone himself.
He is, a favorite across the region and beyond the region. He's a Connellsville native, but is known in much, much larger circles, much wider circles. 85 years old, Mr. Betters is. He certainly doesn't look it, but he's got so much musical experience under his belt. It's just cool to be in the same room as him, really.
You know, he played with Louis Armstrong.
Mm-hmm.
He appeared on The Tonight Show. That makes me a little nervous because he's coming on our show tonight.
Yep.
I think during the Merv Griffin era.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. We kept debating that when we talked to him on the telephone, but he also toured with Ray Charles for a few weeks, for mm-hmm. a period of time. So he is kind of a legend among himself, and during the 10 o'clock hour, we're going to hear him play two songs. Not sure, there could always be a change, but I was told he's going to open up with What a Wonderful World, and because it's New Year's Eve, mm-hmm. he's going to close us out with Auld Lang Syne.
Auld Lang Syne, a classic, yep.
Mm-hmm. So
can't ring in the new year without Auld Lang Syne.
No, can't.
Even if some people don't really know what it means. Auld Lang Syne, I believe, interestingly enough, is translated into the good old days or something of that nature. That's what it means.
The good old days. So talking about the good old days, episode number one, that happened several months ago. It seems like just yesterday we had had people on for the first time. We met Chef. I don't know if our audience knows this because Chef has become a staple around here. But Chef Mario was a one-time guest. He was here to be on the show
mm-hmm.
Just once. He was our first demo. And
we said, hey, we'll keep you.
We'll keep you around. And kind of like a stray cat, maybe. You feed him, he comes back. He feeds us, actually. But
he does.
And he's a good guy. And so we met him for the first time on the first mm-hmm. episode. Had Jason Jack Miller, who has gone on to release some other books throughout the year.
And his lovely bride, Heidi Sue Ruby Miller.
Also
published author.
Published author.
Both of them are writing faculty at Seton Hill. I don't think I had any, no offense to any of my professors who are watching, but I don't think I had any professors that were quite as hip as they are. I think if you say the word hip, that means you're not hip.
That's probably
but,
true.
But they're
That's
very, probably true. Very trendy, very... and just very knowledgeable on a wide array of subjects and very easy to relate with, even though their intelligence and talent is just out of this world.
Yeah. Out of this world, Dave Meredith. He does
good transition.
Yeah, you like that? He does a fantastic talk. I've seen it several times, but he opened up our first show talking about things that were made here in Fayette County. And I don't know if Dave knows this, but he probably set the tone for the rest of the episodes that happened throughout this year, mm-hmm. because he opened up and said, look at all these things in Fayette County, and that we've been duplicating that, maybe on a little different scale each show, by talking about something local from Fayette County.
You know, we'll see a little bit later on our New Year's Eve going live episode, Dan and Barb Clockerty. They run a bartender training program, and they were talking to me just about, you know, some of the other guests that we have scheduled for that New Year's Eve show, and they were just so impressed by the amount of talent we have here in Fayette County, and just the caliber of guests that we're able to come on. And these are all, you know, for the most part, they're all local folks, homegrown talent, and we're so blessed and so grateful to have them on here sharing their gifts with us.
So speaking of homegrown, right from down Route 51, from Smock, the Matarkowski brothers and their good buddy, Jason Kersey, who make up Abacus Jones, mm-hmm. they opened us up in show number one, and really put us at ease. One of my favorite local bands. I've got to know their music. A lot of people, you know, they enjoy cover bands, but don't always get into the music of that crowd. Mm-hmm. Abacus Jones, they opened us up with some great music.
And it's some of their original music. And you might say, you know, anytime you hear original music, it takes a while to get into it. Not really with Abacus Jones. Their stuff is really catchy. It's your toes start tapping pretty quickly. And just the strength of their voices is really something else, and the instrumentation. Jason Kersey plays some kind of drum machine that I don't even completely understand, but I love it.
You know, they came in just from an art opening that they were playing at in Manhattan. Mm-hmm. So their work is musically is recognized far and wide. They had just released a 5-track EP, self-titled Abacus Jones. We have that footage from the first show. If you are a viewer of recent era, you may notice that our logo or branding may be a little bit different back at the beginning.
We continue to evolve.
But the show's evolved. And
we evolve based on folks' feedback, too. That's important to us. So, you know, you're watching the show, continue that conversation with us about what you like, what you don't like. And I tell you what, though, if you don't like Abacus Jones, something's wrong with you.
Absolutely. So why don't we tune into them, look back at that video from episode one. Abacus Jones is going to play Ain't the Way.
That's off that five-track EP.
Off that EP, uh-huh. And then they're going to close that first show with Through With Me.
Through With Me, yeah. That's okay. That's a really catchy one. The beat's very bouncy.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay. Da-da. Ladies and gentlemen, Abacus Jones. Yeah.
your dreams to count flowers. Tomorrow's the day that you try. The time marches on and it won't.
Man, it kind of brings back some memories looking back at episode one and at Abacus Jones.
We were so young then.
yeah, so young. Wet behind the ears. Episode two, though, we changed up the musical styling a little bit for episode two, and we had Mr. Daryl Smith of Outpost. He was our musical guest. He opened us up with a fiddle tune.
That's right. He makes his own instruments. He crafted that fiddle by himself. I think he said it took 450 hours. So much talent. The band Outpost, they started out as a church band at Fort Byrd United Presbyterian Church, I believe that's in Brownsville. And currently, I know Daryl said they just like to play their music to lift people up. So they make it a goal, that band, to play one nursing home each month. Now you might be thinking, okay, they're playing nursing homes, they must be kind of mellow. Well, not really. It's just good American music, and Daryl can sure play a fiddle.
He absolutely can. He's been doing so for over 50 years.
Is that right?
So, seasoned fiddler.
Mm-hmm.
He plays some old country, mm-hmm. but also some rock and roll.
He does. He plays the guitar as well, and I think on the second song that we'll see from episode two, Daryl was playing the guitar and doing a little bit of singing. And this song is not your typical song. It's an Auctioneer song, right?
Absolutely. The Auctioneer. I think that's Leroy Van Dyke.
That's an old one.
Yep. It's been mm-hmm. around for a while.
And there's some fast talking in that song, so it's one that'll get your toes tapping for sure.
He did a real nice job with that.
His grandson, I believe, was initially supposed to join us, had another commitment, but him and his grandson collaborate and play together a good bit. His name is Braden Carey.
I know on the show he was talking to us about the difference of a fiddle and a violin.
Mm-hmm.
He talked a little bit about that.
And it's all about, really, as Daryl told us, it's about the style of music that you're playing that determines, you know, what instrument that is. It's just all about the way it's played.
So, Daryl Smith of Outpost in episode two, we're going to take a look back at that. He's going to open with a fiddle tune and close with a song on guitar, The Auctioneer, by originally Leroy Van Dyke.
was a boy from Arkansas who wouldn't listen to his ma when she told him that he should go to school. He'd sneak away in the afternoon, take a little walk, then pretty soon you'd find him at the local auction barn. He'd stand and listen carefully, then pretty soon he began to see how the auctioneer could talk so rapidly. He said, oh my, it's do or die, I've got to learn that auction cry, gotta make my mark and be an auctioneer. $25 bid and I $30, $30 will you give me $30, make a $30 bid, and mama $30 will you give me $30, hood a bit, $30 bid. $30 bid and I $35, will you give me $35, make a $35 bid, $35, who's gonna bid at that $35 bid? As time went on, he did his best, but all could see he didn't just. He practiced calling bids both night and day. His pap would find him behind the barn, just working up an awful storm as he tried to imitate the auctioneer. His pap said, son, we just can't stand to have a mediocre man selling things at auction using our good name. I'll send you off to auction school, then you'll be nobody's fool, and you can take your place among the best. $35 bid and I $40, $40 will you give me $40, make a $40 bid of the month, $40 will you give me $40, bid, $40 bid. $40 bid and I $45, will you give me $45, make a $45 bid, $45, who's gonna bid it at a $45 bid? Well, from the boy who went to school, there grew a man who played it cool. He came back home a full-fledged auctioneer. The people came from miles around to hear him make that rhythmic sound that filled their hearts with such a happy cheer. The word spread out from shore to shore. He had all he could do and more. He had to buy a plane to get around. Now he's the tops in all the land. Let's pause and give that man a hand. He's the best hillbilly auctioneer.
So, if that fiddle music didn't get your feet tapping, I don't know what will.
When I lived in West Virginia, I used to go to a place in the middle of nowhere. Some of our viewers may have gone there because it's really a destination for a lot of people. It's in Davis and Thomas. I don't know which one because they're both really tiny towns. Really close to each other, Davis and Thomas, West Virginia. And the place is called the Purple Fiddle, and just a lot of great acoustic acts, bluegrass acts come and play there, and folks, and they have good food. Folks come from all around to see them. But I will tell you that Daryl competes with some of the best of them. He's really got it going, and you said 50 years or so he's been playing, so I think that you can tell he's really honed his craft and is an expert fiddler.
So episode 3, we changed musical style a little bit again, and we kind of said age makes no difference, and we brought in the guys from Stereotype, Abergallatin students for the most part, I believe. They were preparing for the AG Regatta, which is down in Point Marion. They had a CD out, Half Step Down. And
we got a copy of that CD, and I know we listened to it a good while after that, and we still have it in our catalog.
Sure. But they opened up with a song called Beautiful Day. It was an original, just a great song.
You hear their music and you want to close your eyes and picture yourself on a beach somewhere. It's really, it's rock and roll. It's got a little bit of a pop feel to it, but it's so, so breezy and light that it's really enjoyable, and it kind of sets a positive, upbeat mood.
It's one of those songs that, you hear from an original artist, an original tune, and in your head, if the right person heard this, it would be on every radio station across the country.
Yep.
And I don't know if
I'm still waiting for my big break.
For your big break?
Yeah.
I don't know if they'd appreciate it, but it's kind of poppy rock.
Mm-hmm.
Not in a bubblegum and kind of way, but it's something that I think a lot of people could
enjoy. It blends the genres, and I think it's not offensive, of course, to folks that don't like rock and roll. It's something that I think a lot of folks of all ages can enjoy. And you mentioned the age of these guys. really, unless we said that, and you can kind of get a look at them. They're young bucks, but you know, they have talent beyond their years.
And they've been playing together for about 4 years when
right.
they were on the show here.
Right. One of the fellas, however, I don't recall his name, but one of the fellas there that was playing with them, he hadn't really played with the band a whole lot. He was filling in for someone else, but he just was so good at playing by ear and picking up on those melodies that you would never know if he wouldn't have said that.
If you remember for that show, you know, because the band's set up on one side of the studio and we're set up on the other, Chef is in another corner, and that night the band was sitting in place while Chef was doing his demo, and he was stirring, and they played some mixing music.
That's
you remember
right,
that?
They did.
We had a lot of fun with them, but we're going to take a look back at Stereotype from episode number 3 of Going Live with FCTV.
This is Beautiful Day.
Saturday, I'm on my way back home. I dread the week as it passes by. Sunday comes and I've got nowhere to go. Then I flash before my is a foundation to happiness. Just live each day without regret. And go through life with this philosophy. And come enjoy my beautiful day with me. Be in my beautiful day. All of the gray clouds go away. All day long the sun shines bright. The infinite stars they glow at night. Me and my beautiful day. All of the gray clouds go away. All day long the sun shines bright. Sometimes it snows, yeah. But we can't wish them away. Just keep dreaming of my beautiful day. Things I did, ready to change, to flip over the page. Cause this is the way I wanna stay.
Time is just ticking away. I mean, it's gonna be a new year, a new day.
It sure is, but not before we look back.
Not before we look back on a couple more things, a couple more episodes.
Because you have to know where you've been to know where you're going.
Is that what they say? I think you might have read that in a fortune cookie. So looking back, episode 6 was the next one we had some music for, and our episode 1 buddy, Joe Matarakowski, who plays with Abacus Jones, came and did some acoustic stuff for us in the studio and helped us out for a little while. And he opened up with Once I Saw for that episode number 6.
Yep. You know, you and I, both big Jackson Browne fans.
Sure.
Jackson Browne has an album out called Solo Acoustic. But I tell you what, a Joe Matarakowski solo acoustic performance is pretty darn special, too.
It is.
It's a whole different vibe, really, than when the three guys are together of Abacus Jones, which is the band, of course, that Joe's sort of the front man and the lead vocalist for. It's a whole different vibe, but it's equally just really fun and pleasant to listen to.
You know, our crew probably doesn't get a whole lot of mention on air because they're behind the scenes. But we had a young lady who was working with us as a camera operator over the summer. And she came in, and she would probably kill me for mentioning this, but Joe had his long hair, and it was, you know, just
lady
done
killer.
So.
Lady killer, Joe Matarakowski.
And I'm talking on the headset to her saying, hey, what's going on with this with this guy coming in, and she was like, I don't know, I'm just amazed, awestruck. She was she was really going after Joe that day. So I don't know, he may have more appeal when he's just Joe Matarakowski.
Yeah.
But another lovely young lady that was with us on that episode was Camry Uhazy. Now, Camry, if you're from Uniontown, especially Uniontown School District,
we've watched Camry grow up.
You may feel like you know this young girl for her entire life, because she was probably 5 or 6 years old singing the national anthem at different events.
She's one of the best national anthem singers I've ever heard.
She's very good, and was very good from a young age.
Mm-hmm.
So she's been making her rounds, doing a little bit in the music industry.
And she is a former Fayette County Idol, I believe, from the teen competition at the Fayette County Fair.
I know she mm-hmm. competed. I didn't mm-hmm. know how she had placed.
Yep.
But she did a cover on the show of Cowboy Casanova, kind of gave it her own twist. And at the time when she was here, she was promoting another event that was coming up, Dance for Dreams, which was a fundraiser for the Uniontown Arts Fellowship.
Camry, in addition to being a singer, has danced for many years, and so just all around talented young lady. And you know, that's what we do. We spotlight talent of all ages, and I'm particularly impressed with how much young and up and coming talent we have in this community and in this region.
So why don't we take a moment and go back and rewatch the tape of Joe Matarakowski doing Once I Saw, and then we'll follow that up with Camry Uhazy, Cowboy Casanova.
Joe.
Once I saw something I wasn't supposed to see. Now it's hard to see things the way that they used to be. Once I had a lot to say, and now I found I'm better off hiding my visions and keeping things hidden. Oh, but after all, I've been misled to worry about something that hasn't been said. Once and in another time, you could say what you really mean. But these days, it seems you should sit back and watch it all.
We talked about a lot of music throughout the night, and I feel a little bit like I'm putting an audition tape together mm-hmm. for Time Life. Like,
yeah.
I'm going to do a compilation CD that you could order or something like that.
Yeah.
Just scroll the things across the screen. Our audience is starting to make their way
easy
in.
Easy payments. Nine easy payments.
Nine easy payments, and we're going to continue to send you stuff forever. our audience is starting to come in and fill up the studio.
Hey, audience.
We're glad that they're going to be with us here tonight, 10 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
We have a great show coming up.
Big show.
Up.
For folks just joining us, this is kind of a look back at the great music that has graced the Fayette TV studio this year as part of our arts and entertainment show going live with FCTV. There's something here for everyone, kind of crossing all genres. We haven't had an opera singer yet, but I may have one in mind for next year.
Next year we're going to get them on?
Yeah, hope
okay.
so.
So we've talked about Joe Matarakowski over and over, But he did a few episodes for us.
Yeah.
He did Abacus Jones, then he did a solo acoustic, and then we needed to replace someone real quick, and he came back in the studio for episode number 7.
Joe's a good friend to going live and to Fade
TV.
He's
a great friend to us. But at this point in time, it felt like, hey, Joe, you've been here forever. So he sang a song called Going Home, and then he got himself the heck out of the studio. But he was here for episode number 7, played a song, Going Home. Why don't we take a look back at Joe Matarakowski, Going Home.
Think I'm going home again tonight. I think I'm going back to make it right. I don't regret everywhere I've been, but I've had enough of remembering when. I think I'm going home again tonight. Think I'm gonna break away tonight. I think I'll break away to save my life. 'Cause breaking out from where I've been could only help me to finally win. I think I'm gonna break away tonight. To ever show that I'm prepared to let it go. Will summer ever snow, and will I remain this time? Too much are all the lies, when apathy outweighs the prize. I can't forget the cries, oh, especially when they're mine. I think I'm gonna make a day tonight. I think I'll take the day to make it right. I don't know how I'm gonna make it when there's no one left here to show me in. I think I'm gonna make a day tonight.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. You know, this year I've been teased a little bit because at the beginning of all the shows, especially when we have, you know, the live studio audience and everything, they're clapping and carrying on, and I'm trying to get
trying
the show
to do some
started,
crowd control.
Trying to say, come on, welcome, welcome, and I say it like 4 or 5 times.
And everyone has their tagline.
Because then, what do you, always yell like you have
some, episode 5!
Episode 5, wherever we are. Episode 9 is what we're going to talk about.
Okay, that's where we are.
That's where we are, yeah.
Okay.
Episode 9, I'm sure you yelled that at the beginning of the show. But we had a young lady with us who is a fantastic songwriter, and she performs her own music. She's a singer-songwriter. I always tend to fall for the singer-songwriter type of music. How about you?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Well, going back to James Taylor, who was one of my dad's favorites and one of mine, and James Taylor often collaborated with Carole King and Carly Simon, both good ones. But this young lady could be the next Carole King or Carly Simon or Taylor Swift, maybe. That was a big influence for her. As well as Miranda Lambert, two big influences for Caitlin Rittenhouse, who we're talking about.
So, you know, no matter what type of art you're involved in, whether it be painting or dancing or singing or, you know, whatever what we do here, mm-hmm. it's really all the art of storytelling. Mm-hmm. And I think that's where this young lady knows what she's doing. She's 17 years old. Like I said, singer, songwriter. Been doing music since she was 11, so she hasn't been doing it all her life, but she has a few years under her belt. She was the 2011 Fayette County Teen Idol. She was a talent winner in the Mount Pleasant Glass Festival talent show. And, you know, just does some great original music.
Mm-hmm. She had me, you know, I never claimed to be a He-Man or, you know, a stone-hearted person, but she had me little misty-eyed at the Fayette County Fair when we were out there this year. She did an excellent song. Lost her aunt, I believe it was, to cancer, and just did a beautiful tribute to her. But the songs that she did on our show were a little bit more upbeat, but just as heartfelt. You know, Caitlin Rittenour has this smile that really adds to her whole stage presence. She will melt your heart. She'll capture your heart, and I think you're going to be seeing big things from her.
Absolutely. She opened up our show, episode 9, with Wild Rose. And then she closed the show out with There's No Place Like Home, which was a new song. Mm-hmm. I think it's going to be good to see her again. I understand her and her family are in the studio audience during the 10 o'clock
hour. Joining us a little bit later. Yep.
It's kind of like Old Faces Night
Home
here.
Week.
Yeah, Old Home Week.
Yep.
And we're all...
That's good because
some people coming in that are going to be with us. And
I had someone that was in the studio for the last show. They were just really, really enthralled by this whole process. And you know, there's some kinks to the whole process. We know that better than anyone. But just the amount of creative energy and the atmosphere in here. If you haven't been part of our studio audience for Going Live with FCTV, we hope you will join us in the future. And you can follow us on Facebook to learn a little bit more about that. But anyway, the person came in, they said, man, I really like this. And I said, well, you're part of the family now. And that is kind of how it is. Our crew and our cast here, everyone back in the control room, the students that from AGTV that help us operate the cameras for the show, and all of the guests, that some of them have been returning guests. We've talked about the boys from Abacus Jones, Gennaro Cellurel, our friend from Pompadour Salon. He's been on several times. He cut your hair on the air one time before. And it's a family, and you as our viewer, you're part of that family, and you're welcome to be part of that family.
Well, I think it's appropriate then that we're spending tonight with family here at the Fayette TV studio for a new year. Why don't we take a minute out and listen to both of those songs? We talked about Caitlin, she'll be coming in. Why don't we play Wild Rose first, and then There's No Place Like Home.
Put some tap water in my grandma's cup, and I filled it up with daisies and buttercups. And we picked tea and berries down by the creek. We'd eat a few and the rest were saved for jelly. I was happy young and still had time to grow all the ingredients I needed to become a wild rose. There's no taming the heart of something wild. Time is endless in a world of child. From that smile to those barefoot little toes, I was a spirit on the run. A wild rose. Pap showed me sweet clover and old birch trees. Both you could chew on and taste the flavor so sweet. I had scars on my knees from that old peach tree and jumping off a battle tree swing. Imagination and courage helped me grow. I was born to become. Even though it's take hold of my hand. I promise forever to be your best friend, but please don't ever let go and move on. 'Cause I finally found a place that I belong. And it's true what they say, that at the end of the day, there's no place like home. Caught in a moment so sweet, hold me close and I'll breathe you in deep with your eyes, so tender and kind. There'll be no such thing as a word time. I've finally found my one true place. I can be myself where I feel safe. A miracle, you're my saving grace.
Episode 10.
Episode 10. Lucky number 10. Lucky number 10 brought us a lot of different things. It brought us another style of music that we hadn't had before.
Right.
Something with a little bit of a gospel R&B feel to it. I'm a big Otis Redding fan.
Me too.
You know, Otis Redding, he tells a
story.
Taken
before his time.
Yeah.
And but not without leaving us a whole catalog of awesome music.
So one of the people that this young lady started to sing along to her grandmother's
records, yep. Mm-hmm.
With was Otis Redding, and Charisse Johnson Moore was our musical guest for episode number 10. She said that she had a gospel influence, grew mm-hmm. up singing in church, like we said, grew up with her grandmother's record player, was a third place finalist at Uniontown's Got Talent. And, man, she was good.
You know, Charisse is someone that actually reached out to me. A lot of times, you know, I hear an artist somewhere because I love local music, and sometimes hear them at our local venues and things like that. And, I'm begging you to come on our show. And normally, we don't have to do a lot of begging. All the bands that we've worked with and the artists have been very gracious, giving of their time and talent here on the show. But Charisse, as I said, was one that actually reached out to me and said, hey, you know, I love to sing. I saw, I think she read our column in the Herald Standard that we were seeking local talent to join us on the show. And she said, here, check out my YouTube videos. And I think you were with me at that time. And I said, I'm calling her right now. I was blown away. I was blown away.
She did a great job on the show. She opened up with Change Is Gonna Come.
That's a Sam Cooke song, I believe.
Yeah, Sam Cooke. And closed out with If I Ain't Got You.
Alicia Keys. Yeah.
And she had some heart. She had some soul that she sang with. Now, you mentioned people that contact you.
Mm-hmm.
We kind of laugh every Monday morning because you do a Sunday column in the Herald Standard, the local newspaper, and they're a great partner with us here at the television station. But Monday mornings, we always get the emails because your email address is generally in there saying, hey, we have this idea, we have that idea. Some of them are completely off the wall, and some of them you're like, man, I'm glad this person shared this with us.
But we welcome them all. Please email us.
So how do they get a hold of you?
My email is David. D-A-V-I-D dot Slusaric. I don't know if we have a CG here at the bottom of the screen, a computer graphic, but I'll spell that out for you. It's S as in Sam, L-U-S-A-R-I-C-K at coordinated 360. I made a little
air
at symbol.
You did that pretty well.
at coordinated360.com, David.Slusaric at coordinated360.com. We're also on Facebook, though. That may be a lot easier for
and
folks.
Twitter.
And Twitter. You can look up Going Live with FCTV. We have our own website. It's goinglivefctv.com. And then Going Live with FCTV also on Twitter and Facebook.
Facebook.com/goinglivefctv.
Mm-hmm.
You can find us. You can contact us. You can let us know what's going on. We're always looking for community involvement. In fact, community involvement, maybe we can talk just a moment or two about this. We have a new internship program going
on. We do. We have an opportunity for high school students, actually high school graduates. We've worked with some high school students previously, and as I said, Albert Gallatin television students have been a big part of our show. We work with Laurel Highlands and Brownsville High School, and there's an open invitation to all of our local schools to kind of participate and share content with us. But getting back to the point here, we are now extending an opportunity to high school graduates, folks that might be interested or pursuing the study of marketing, broadcast, communications, and there's a chance to really be involved in this finished product here. And as I said, it's an exciting time to be involved in Going Live with FCTV because we continue to grow and we continue to evolve. We have some really exciting things ahead in the new year. So just go to our website, as I mentioned, goinglivefctv.com. And there's a tab to click on that says internship program, and you can learn all the details. And there's really a lot of options trying to be flexible with different student schedules and school schedules. We have internship hours available during the upcoming spring semester. We have some hours available over the summer and then again in the fall.
Yeah, so the great ways to get involved with our show here. Going Live with FCTV, but
you might be even able to work with some of your some of the collegiate institutions and maybe get college credit.
Absolutely. Why don't we toss now to Charisse, and she's going to open us up. Change Is Gonna Come, and then we'll play If I Ain't Got You.
You're going to love it, Charisse Johnson Moore.
Hang around. It's been a long
know the change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother, and I say, brother, help me please. But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Oh, there were times that I thought I would last for long, but now I think I'm able to carry on. It's been a long time coming, but I know the change gonna come. Oh, yes it will. Then I go to my brother, and I say, brother, will you help me, please? But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees.
For a fountain that promises
is forever young. Some people need a dozen roses, 'cause that's the only way to prove you love them. Hand me the world on a silver platter, and what good would it be with no one to share and no one who truly cares for me? Some people want it all, but I don't want nothing at all. If it ain't you, baby, if I ain't got you, baby. Some people want diamond rings, some just want everything, but everything means nothing if I ain't got you. Some people want it all, but I don't want nothing at all. If it ain't you, baby, if I ain't got you, baby. Want everything, but everything means nothing if I ain't got you, yeah. If I ain't got you with me, baby, ooh, ooh. So nothing in this whole wide world don't mean a thing. If I ain't got you with me, baby.
So I don't know if you know this. You might have picked up from Dave and I's love of music that we started ourselves out in the entertainment industry spinning records.
That's right.
Dave did a little bit of news radio as well as disc jockeying, and we've done some live parties, backed off from that a little bit, but still have a business where we do that.
DJ Dazzlin' Dave still gets out a little
Dazzlin'
bit.
Dazzlin' Dave, he still puts his dad's shoes on. We were just reminiscing while we were playing back about some of our favorite guests at DJ events at different parties. And Dave had mentioned...
Seems like an appropriate conversation, but a lot of our viewers are probably at New Year's parties right
probably,
now.
Probably, probably. You had just mentioned that there was a party where we weren't allowed to play Proud Mary for whatever reason.
It was a very strict request, yeah. It was pretty dangerous if we were to play that.
The wedding with no disco, that they danced to disco all night long.
I think this lovely bride didn't completely understand what all constituted disco. Some of the songs that she actually requested to be played were disco songs, but the moment the word disco was mentioned in
what
the...
What song did you play?
It may have been Burn Baby Burn Disco Inferno? I don't know, but she... we were
accosted?
Barraged, is that a word? At the DJ table, and she said, I can't believe I'm hearing disco at my own wedding. And
unfortunately, I wasn't at that one, but... But good times. And we've had some good times this last year.
We sure have.
I can't believe the clock is ticking so quickly, and the year's slipping right before us. You know, we've had some up-and-coming people on the show as far as musical guests, but then...
And then we've had some legends.
We've had some legends, and episode 11 was one of those legends. Bobby Reed. You know, when you had mentioned in a production meeting that Bobby Reed was who we were going to ask, I didn't think there was any way he was going to do the show. I really had my doubts for a few minutes.
Not that he's not a generous fella, but he just has a lot of demands on his time.
And he's booked for a lot of events, so to come in and, you know, come in and do something, I really, Bobby Reed was actually requested as through our viewer feedback. A gentleman had requested that we have Bobby Reed on, so you went ahead and gave it a try, and we got a yes pretty instantly from him, actually, and he came in. Now, if you don't know Bobby Reed, he is the jazz legend of the area.
So many folks have been going to see Bobby Reed weekly, Thursday nights. His gig used to be at the Holiday Inn, and now he's at DeMarco's Bistro and Cantina right here in downtown Uniontown. It's a great venue. Bobby Reed, and he has his loyal fan base.
Now, he opened up with some music from the 1940s. I think it was probably something with Duke Ellington.
Duke Ellington, I believe.
And then
that's a blast from the past, right, folks?
He closed us out during that show with Frosty the Snowman. But it was the jazziest Frosty the Snowman I have ever
heard. I don't want
heard.
To hear Frosty the Snowman any other way after that. You know?
No, I think he made Frosty the Snowman a much cooler cat than he actually is.
Probably,
you know what I mean?
Yeah. Top hats haven't been in style for a while, but
Frosty's pulled it out. Yeah. I think we're going to pull off top hats tonight.
Oh, no.
I understand, actually, that Frosty won't be the only one with them. It is New Year's. So we have all the apparel set and ready to go. Harry's been wearing a hat for 3 weeks over there, our cameraman Harry, dedicated fella. And later on this evening, we do want to get a thank you out to our entire crew.
But absolutely.
We'll mention them maybe when we come back. So episode 11 was Bobby Reed.
When I was back in the control room, heard Bobby Reed warming up, I had to live tweet and said, Bobby Reed is in the studio right now. I just, it's just so cool. It's like I said, with Harold Betters, the same thing is the case. And some of these other local legends and regional legends, really, it's the energy when they're in the room and, it's a science for them. It's an art and a science, but they've just polished their act. And there's so much life and love and energy that they put into their music.
Now, Bobby's trio had been playing together for 20-plus years. He had a holiday CD that was out. It's still available at Judy's Do Re Mi and its soundtrack. You mentioned that they play at DeMarco's Thursdays, 7 to 10 p.m. Really amazing how active and the great music he has. Mm-hmm. And, as most people who know him obviously know, or if you saw the show, Bobby's blind.
Mm-hmm. He wasn't born blind, as he explained to us, but he had a detached retina, I believe, and at the time there was no way to really treat it, so he lost all of his vision, I think, when he was 11 years old. He started out as a drummer, Bobby told us, and then he fell in love with the organ, and been playing the little, I don't remember the technical name, but sort of a keyboard-style organ for about 45 years now, and he's just got that act completely down. He's got a couple great gentlemen backing him up as well on drums, and
had a trumpeter.
He had a trumpeter, yeah, saxophonist, I believe.
Oh, I'm sorry, yeah.
Yep.
He had said that being blind has never been a problem, a deterrent, or a stumbling block in his life. That he was given courage and he was given music, and music's kind of the gift that he keeps giving out. So I think maybe we should take a break and listen to some Duke Ellington as performed by Bobby
Reed. The great Bobby Reed.
And then he'll keep us in this holiday mood that we have going on with a very jazzy Frosty the Snowman. Bobby Reed. I can't believe we have Bobby Reed on the show, and I can't believe we have a lot of the people on the show that we do.
That's right.
Not just our musical guests, but everyone.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people have accomplished so much, and I think that's one of the reasons why I'm so passionate about the show. Mm-hmm. Is because we get to share those things with the viewers at home and the viewers in the audience. And we've already talked tonight about how you can be an audience member potentially. Follow us on Twitter and Facebook and learn about upcoming shoots. Just if we can kind of spread the message, the gospel of our good old hometown here, we're doing good work. But we had a musical guest during episode 12, Martyr Kanan is the name. And he opened us up with a song called Walls Come Tumbling Down. Why don't you tell us a little bit about Martyr? You saw him and thought, hey, he'd be great for the show. He's a good fit.
Our friends at the Uniontown area YMCA, along with some other folks, sponsored a Battle of the Bands this year at the Fayette County Fair. And I had the pleasure of filming that for Fayette TV. And there were just a ton of talented bands. Martyr really stood out to me. His name is Michael Muscannon III. And he has a drummer that he works with pretty closely. His name's Charlie Keel, I believe. And they've only been playing together for maybe 9 months, but they just have a chemistry between them. I don't always like comparisons because, you know, each musician, and that's true for everyone that's been on our show, everyone has their own unique style. However, I would say that if you like Jon Bon Jovi, especially some of his more mellow tracks, and if you like Edwin McCain, just some good kind of introspective rock and roll music, and heartfelt lyrics.
It's heartfelt.
Heartfelt lyrics, and there's kind of a spiritual undertone to some of Martyr's lyrics. Martyr Kanan, it's a duo, and they're pretty young in terms of how long they've been playing, but you really can't tell that. They're pretty polished.
Well, let's tune in now to a recording of Martyr Kanan when he was on episode 12, not that long ago. Walls Come Tumbling Down, he opens up.
And the second song, I believe, is Living on the Edge.
Okay.
once was a man, stand for a dream that we could all live in peace and harmony, to be free, to be just what we want to be. But does anybody understand equality when the world comes tumbling down? Should I spread a little butter and jam just to sweeten the bread that is our resistance? But instead, us in the soul continue to stand when the war comes on me down. When the world stops turning around, will we recognize the sin of the war tumbling down?
step to forgiveness. One last step is to live it on the
Well, hey, thanks for sticking with us through the review this evening. We have some great stuff coming up tonight. We have some live music that's going to happen from the 12 o'clock hour on. We have an episode of our show that's going to be taking place in front of a live studio audience that's going to be on at 10.
Don't touch that dial.
Don't go anywhere.
We're bringing it back.
Do people still have dials?
That's true. That's why that expression kind of.
Yeah, I think it was phased out with the dial itself and the rotary telephone and all of those good things.
I wreaked havoc with my Graham's rotary phone when I was little because to me it was just another toy, and I don't know, I was calling some long distance numbers accidentally.
What was great
is when
you would pull that, especially like the 9, and you pulled it the whole way around, and then it would back around the other direction. Mm-hmm. That was a lot of fun. You know, our kids aren't going to know the rotary telephone.
There may be still some people out there that have rotary phones, because you hear when you get those automated menus, if you don't have a touchtone phone, you know, stay on the line and someone will take care of you. So perhaps there are some folks out there still clinging to tradition, and there's nothing wrong with that, folks. I want you to know that I accept you.
I bet Harry has a rotary phone.
I'm sure. No, Harry's a very modern fella.
He's technologically advanced, but
He does have a respect for tradition.
He does. Mm-hmm. I bet one room in his house has a rotary phone.
Harry Metz, our chief videographer for the shows and really a loyal part of our whole Going Live family, our team.
We mentioned Harry, so we have to mention a couple other people that are here with us this evening. It is no small feat to do a show this size for as many episodes as we've done. We generally, believe it or not, run three or more cameras here in the studio. It's all switched live in our control room. We have an audio engineer that's on with us every time. So opposed to some of our other shows where you can come in and one or two people can kind of handle it, we have a team, a good-sized team that we need to have for every show, not to mention the people that are just telling people what's going on and getting people in and helping people carry things. The bands bring in kind of an entourage that help them get set up, but that's completely necessary and necessary to help them get out in a timely manner. So there's a lot of people that have put some hard work in this year to making sure that this show has happened, not to mention the station itself. But I want to give a couple thank yous. You know, we mentioned Harry already. Eric Nuttall.
Eric is our director and audio engineer.
Mm-hmm. He is also a teacher or faculty member at Abergallatin Senior High School. And he brings with him his advanced students from their AV program.
Some of the best and brightest.
And they come and they do the show and help us out with video. I believe tonight we have with us, and pardon me for having to look, but we have Cody Grimm on camera, Chris Little on camera, George Hammond, and Brett McCourt. Tonight's show's actually, Eric has stepped back a little bit and he's helping to supervise things, but tonight's being directed by Emily Dillinger. Our audio is being run by Madison Johnson. So those are...
Thank you, students.
Those are some people that are giving some time up to come in and help us out because it does, like I said,
and it takes
a large crew.
It takes guts, though, for the students to do that because, I mean, you're part of a production that we record basically or many times we're truly live. Sometimes we have to pre-record some segments, but, you know, there's not really room for a lot of mistakes, and they're kind of put on the spot, and they just kind of go to it. And yeah. I think it's been a good way, and I hope Mr. Nettle and the students would agree, it's been a good way for students to develop their confidence, develop their skills, and you know that's part of what Fayette TV is all about. You know, we believe in educational opportunities for our local students.
So we have all of those people on the crew we've had in this week, because this week has been really hectic. The past couple weeks have been really hectic with a number of different things. We have had Chris Boucher, who's one of the guys that works for us.
Seasonally.
He's seasonal. He's in college, but he works for Coordinated 360. He has moved everything on the set around two or three times. My sister, Maria, she's home from college and working with us a little bit. She was kind of a driving force with our Fayette County Fair this year.
She sure was.
Because she did the summer there. So we want to send a quick thank you out to them because they keep a lot of our production stuff in the background moving while they're here with us.
We want to thank the Redstone Foundation as well, which is sort of the branch under which this TV station operates. And they've put their trust in us and allowed us to produce this show and some programming for them. We appreciate that. Muriel Nuttall, the director of the Redstone Foundation.
You know, when we sat down and we started to talk about this show and could it happen, would it happen, we talked about who would host it, who would co-host it. You know, we had a lot of different things in mind, and I think it's worked out well. But I have to thank you for co-hosting with me and Chef. I mean, we talked earlier in the evening. He was here for one episode, and he stuck around with us, and he's doing some big things. He's got his radio show, the
Mario
Cook Show,
radio show. Uh-huh.
On WMBS.
Wimbus, as they call it.
As they call it. And also, it's a great podcast that you can get online. He's doing television
he's
appearances.
He's doing that with our friend Bill Alexander.
Absolutely, and Bill's here a lot of evenings as well, mm-hmm. When we have a show. But he is also doing some appearances with KDKA and some of the mm-hmm. other Pittsburgh stations.
Developing his own line of spices. I'm not sure if you mentioned that.
In a regional television show out in Johnstown. So,
and he's on chefhangout.com.
So he's a busy guy, and we're really thankful that he has stayed with us throughout the year. Mm-hmm. So, you know.
And our sponsors. We have to.
We couldn't do it without them.
We have to recognize them.
We're going to talk a little later in the evening about some new sponsors we have coming on, but throughout the year we've had a number of people who have said, hey, we want to support what you're doing and help you out.
We did that two-hour special out at the Fayette County Independence Day celebration this year. That's at the Uniontown Mall and sponsored by the members of the Fayette County Chamber of Commerce. And we needed some additional resources for that broadcast to make it happen. We needed a stage, and so we had stage sponsors. And we did a broadcast of the fireworks, and businesses stepped forward to become our fireworks sponsor. So we've just been, you know, we understand Fayette TV going live, both a little bit of a fledgling, young operation. I think we've grown quickly, but a large part of that is our community, our business partners have put their faith and trust in us, and We sincerely appreciate that.
So we've mentioned a couple times throughout the evening how we feel like we're with family. And mm-hmm. and we've just mentioned everyone, no better way to spend the holidays than with family. And that's what we're doing tonight. Now, another member of our family, she's a member of the production crew a lot of times. But tonight you're going to get to see the talent that she has to be in front of the camera instead of behind it. Mm-hmm. Taylor Hackley. Taylor has worked for Coordinated 360, done work for the television station. She is also an aspiring singer, and she's going to do some holiday music, which she did in episode 13, and we're going to roll that back for you here this evening. So if you were watching on Christmas Eve, you got to enjoy this once already. But Taylor did Silent Night and Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. And
it kind of in a little bit of a jazzy style. She's got a really unique quality and tone to her voice, and she's been inspired by some of the greats over the years.
So it wasn't just her doing holiday music for us. Brownsville Band also came in for our holiday special, which aired on Christmas Eve.
I want to thank...
episode 13.
Yeah, I want to thank director Mr. Greg Johnson of the Brownsville High School Band for cooperating with us in this venture and allowing his band to invade the studio here, and just a great group of students.
So we're going to go right now to Taylor Hackley, and we'll play back her music from episode 13, and a couple selections from the Brownsville Band, as well as maybe a couple selections that you might not have got to hear. The
bonus footage
weren't included in the final broadcast of our Christmas Eve show, but we have them on tape, and we're going to play them back for you. We're going to break our broadcast directly following them, and we'll play some of the Wally Ginger Orchestra, so there's great music that's coming up for you. That'll Wally Ginger's going to be starting at 11, but don't change your dial, because at 10 o'clock we have a episode of the show.
We sure do.
And we already talked about Harold Betters is going to be on that episode of the show.
Mr. Trombone
himself. So there's a lot coming up this evening. When we come back, we'll be starting the 10 o'clock episode of Going Live with FCTV. But for now, we're going to enjoy some music from the Brownsville Band and Miss Taylor Hackley.
Thanks for watching, folks. Enjoy the tunes.
Glory.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Here we are, as in olden days, happy golden days. If the faith.